up. It's a Poltergeist 5000 up. Angry, angry, August, August, angry, angry, August, August. What? Pardon me. Welcome back to more Dark Souls. In the last episode, we explored New Londo. And, oh shoot, you know what? I don't have those 30,000 souls that I was carrying around. Well, that's fine. We can just use some soul. We can just use a soul of a brave warrior. Ooh, a brave warrior! Ha! I wonder if that's even going to be close to enough to upgrade our claymore. In the last episode, we explored New Londo Ruins. We drained the water. We found the boss. We took one stab at the boss, but we were very weakened from our excursion, and we didn't last very long at all. But we picked up the very large ember! So we can bring it over here to Andre, and he says...
That might be the finest. The finest.
Yes, 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 yes. Jeez, just stop talking. Read your line and then stop talking. Okay, so now we can upgrade our claymore to... Oh, really? Alright, that uses regular Titanite shards for some reason. We can upgrade our claymore... to a claymore plus 11! And there you go, we've finally broken through that barrier. Now we can get even stronger. I should upgrade this. This was the weapon that I actually tried to get a lot on my first playthrough. I tried to get this weapon, and I never could get it. I never got it to drop, but I would love to use that. There you go, our weapon. Our claymore is now maxed. Claymore plus 15. And that's pretty fucking sweet. Oh my god! Holy shit! The Dragon Greatsword takes 10,000 souls! And that's just to upgrade it! Holy crap, that's to upgrade it one time. That's amazing! That's amazing. Okay, anyway. Does this actually... Yeah, it does upgrade the stability. Well, you know what? I kind of want to upgrade the Crest Shield, but the Crest Shield takes Twinkling Titanite, and it's pretty expensive, too. All right. Maybe not, then.
Don't get yourself killed. I'm Freddy.
Yeah. So let's see what we got for our armor in terms of damage protection. Damage protection, lucky goggles. I can use the gargoyle helm, I guess. Oh, but I gotta make sure I keep my equip load under 20. The black sorcerer hat has what's the best thing I have for magic defense on a hood? I think tit for tat, it's probably the black sorcerer hat. That looks so dumb. I don't want to wear that. It looks so dumb. It's so dumb. Just put the gargoyle helm back on. Yeah, what the heck. And for shadow garb, we can put on the black sorcerer cloak that has black leather armor. I can't even believe I'm saying that. Leather armor. Yeah, geez, already. Black leather boots. Sorcerer gauntlet. Those are heavier than the black leather glove? No, they're not. Okay, never mind. Not sure what that was all about. Why it looked like they were. I don't want to wear a skirt, because skirts are oogly. But, there you go. Yes, I think this will work for our fight against the four kings. And our weapon is so much stronger now! 257 plus 157 more. Like, oh my god. That's crazy. Yeah, so I guess I'll meet you. You know what? I'll meet you on the elevator down to New Londo Ruins. You know what? The bridge. How about that? And you know what else I'm gonna do? Ba boom. Wait, I didn't need to use two humanity for that.
Oh, look at how cute my chubby cheeks are. Oh, I'm so cute.
Oh, Okay, well, I was going to say, okay, I'm back, but you were watching most of that. Now, I'm coming in a little bit early here because there's a distinct possibility that I might get invaded. I don't know how popular this area is for PvP, but, The reason I reversed my hollowing there is because I'm actually just gonna rush the boss again before exploring the rest of the area, because there's an NPC summon that I want to show for this fight, but I don't necessarily want to try and actually beat the fight with it, because it's not a very good summon for the fight. Like, mechanically, it almost makes the fight harder. But I want to show it because it's a character I really like. Oh my god, one hit! Yeah, baby. Yes, I'm just gonna try and make it through here quickly. But I don't want to try and sprint past the dark wraiths because I don't know how reliable that. Oh god, really? There's a whole line of guests. God damn. That show's getting on my nerves! Okay, anyway, let's just sprint through here. So this guy's here, and I'm just gonna run past him because I don't even give a shit. Bye! Ghosts! 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 I don't know if they can attack me while I'm in here, but anyway, once you get in here... Oh my god, they're following me! They're following me in here! Once you get in here, I don't think they're gonna pose a threat anymore, and there should be... a summon sign here. For an old friend we haven't seen in a while. I don't know exactly where it is, but... Oh, you know what? Shit. Hello, it's time to wake up. The summon sign's not gonna be past the boss fog. I'm back. Dang it. Oh, if I hadn't whiffed the backstab there, it would have been so perfect. Oh, I'm so mad. Okay, whatever. Okay, I'm back. Sorry about that. Sorry about my stupidity, my stupidliest, my dumb beyond, my dumb BA 2D3, and there's a ghost. There's a whole line of guests. What the hell? Teleport, Dark Wraith, teleport. Dude, what do you piss off? There we go. Die! I don't remember exactly where this summon sign is, but I think I have a vague memory of it. I'm gonna have to kill this guy, though. Which is not gonna be fun with a ghost hanging around, with multiple ghosts hanging around. I think it's over here. Oh, Jesus Christ. How the hell did he not see me? This is bad. Where is Beatrice's summon sign? I didn't think that was gonna go. I didn't think that was gonna cause me to go apeshit. I was just trying to be funny there. Okay, I was looking in the right place at least. Oh, I have them equipped already. But Okay. If you want it to go that way, then that's fine. Oh my god, what a pain in the ass. Gee, I didn't die a single time on the way in, and now I've died three times looking for fucking... Well, I've died twice. Well, actually, no, I didn't die twice. I died once. I actually homeward boned out after the second... Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, I need you to... Come on. Come at me, bro. Yeah, I knew he was gonna do some teleport, Mario. Teleport, Darkwraith! Teleport! What are you doing, dude? Are you on some bad netcode, boy? What's wrong with you? Boy, I said boy! I say you're pissing too loud! Oh, hi. Oh, Jesus Christ. Boy, that was fast. Okay, I'm just gonna... Whoa! Okay, that did less damage than I thought it was gonna do. Jeez. I can't remember the last time I actually got hit by that. That was cool. I am curious if I had had an extra humanity, if it would have taken it away, because I'm pretty sure that's what that's supposed to do. There you are. I don't need to two-hand for those guys anymore, probably. Okay, I know there's more ghosts around here. Because the problem is that all the ghosts that we killed on the way to draining the water, you know, now they're just up and they'll aggro to you while you're wandering around down here and like come and kick your ass. Okay, I think apparently it's right here. Yeah, sure enough, it's right here. Here we go. It's Beatrice. Man, you actually get a better look at her here than you did in the Darkroot Garden. Okay, so you don't actually want to fight her for this boss. She's actually not a good fit against these guys at all, because I think they have like pretty high magic defense, and she is a pure mage. And because of the extra HP that they give the boss to balance you having a helper, you know, they end up. You usually end up having to do more damage yourself to beat them. And that's a problem in this fight, because, again, not getting ganked is very dependent on your ability to kill the individual kings before more spawn. Hey, Beatrice. I'm prepared for you to fuck me on this. God, this... Oh my god, this is so unsettling. I love this boss fight. Like, just... aesthetically, because it's so freaky. Whoa, ow. Oh my god, that really homes in. Okay, I need you to... Yeah, we're doing a lot more damage now, though. Careful. But see how, this isn't really that much of an improvement, and she's already taken a lot of damage. So, the aggro draw could actually be pretty useful, but... Yeah, like, if she wasn't here, we probably would have had this guy dead already. It's of debatable value to have Beatrice with you here. And you know, what's actually interesting is that... I think you actually find her armor here. Like, not here, but behind the boss door or something. After you beat these guys, that's when you find her armor set. So you can actually... So basically, the implication is that she tried to fight these guys and died. Because she wasn't, because she wasn't a good match for them. Okay, I should back off. That said, this is going pretty... Dude, would you stop? Oh no, Beatrice! Oh, that's bad. Ugh. God, that's... Now, thankfully, these guys really don't tend to... Okay, there we go. There's one dead. Yeah, these guys will spawn in, like, one at a time every, like, few minutes. Every minute or so, like, I think is about how often they spawn. So... Yeah, thankfully, their attack patterns are pretty... Ooh, is that a grab? Well, he grabbed me. It sure was. Please don't kill me instantly. Oh, God. That's fine. Okay, we're actually gonna win this. I don't believe it. We actually won this after summoning Beatrice. Yeah, the nice thing is that you also don't have to finish off the last one. All you have to do is empty their health bar. So all I need to do is hit this guy one more time and we win this. There you go. Oh! Man, that's scary. It's like something out of Silent. It's like the shot that plays like right after you land the killing blow on the final boss in Silent Hill 2, where it shows like the final boss's head like at the same angle and like shaking, like overcranked. That actually went pretty well. Good job, Beatrice. Sorry you died, and now you're gonna die because you're gonna try and fight them on your own, and then you're gonna die, and then we're gonna find your armor. So anyway, I guess that's just the way the toast toasts. Oh, you know, we lost those 30,000 souls we had, too. Because we, died. Let's bring our strength up to 35. How about it? You know what, actually, let me get 2 attunement slots. Because I actually need 2 attunement slots to set, Great Chaos Fireball. It takes up 2 slots. But now we have Great Chaos Fireball. I don't know why I didn't put that on earlier. Because that actually would have been pretty helpful in that area. Oh, man, this is so inconvenient. Because now I want to go finish exploring this area, but in order to do that, I have to warp back to Firelink and then meet you back down here. So let's do that. Whoops, I didn't mean to do that. Man, you ain't gonna be able to hear that shit at all. Jeez. I'm gonna have to edit that in better in post. Aw, man! If you can make that jump just right, you'll land on the wall, take no fall damage, and then roll slide off onto the ground beneath it and still take no fall damage. It's like the coolest thing ever, and I only managed to do it in the middle of a cut before. I'm so mad. I'm like an angry dad. Man, dad. What is it, Aaron? What? What are you talking about? Okay, anyway. Let's put on something good. Let's put on the Covetous Gold Serpent Ring. Just keep that on basically all the time, because it's always nice to have. Not that we actually need Titanite Slabs to upgrade anything more. In this game, you only use Titanite Slabs to upgrade armor, to upgrade stuff to the max normally. Like, through normal infusion? Or through no infusion, I guess? As it were. In Dark Souls 3, you use a Titanite Slab to complete basically any infusion. So, yeah. Ooh, hey, buddy. These things are so kind of funny. Like, they're just, like... Because they're just like these armored skeletons. I don't know. Something about the fact that they just have a skull for a face I find amusing. Because it's like so not what you'd expect to see. Yeah, you do aggro, man. You see me from far away. You're like standing in a shed and you still react to me. Ow. Ow! Ow! Oh my god, dude! Jesus Christ, I can't believe you didn't kill me with that! Jeez! Wow! Oh my god, I'm gonna put on the Ring of Steel Protection. That is ridiculous. Cause we got a few more of these guys to deal with exploring the rest of this area. Strange creature up. Oh jeez, hi. Okay, I'm not gonna fuck around anymore. We're gonna fish for backstabs and that's all we're gonna do. Boom. No more Mrs. Nice Paul Lagasta. We're gonna do what works, and we're not gonna compromise that. Large Soul of Crab Knight. in here? My god! Ooh, careful. Yeah, there's some dark rites and really inconvenient spots down here. Boom! No problem. But how'd you get out the TV? Is there actually that much more to explore here? I don't even remember. Dark. Why are so many people putting dark and getting a bunch of thumbs up for it? Should I put down dark here? And why is it always that guy saying it? Okay. This is where the elevator that we could have taken after draining the water, this is where it would have led. It would have led us right down here. This is the door on the other end of it. Apparently there actually isn't that much down here. Alright. So, I'm thinking, oh right, I was gonna look at my rings. Do I have the Thunderstone plate? Yes, I do. I'm gonna try and, maybe I can try and run past these drakes. And, get what's behind here, because there's some cool stuff here. But the thing is that they're all gonna aggro, like, at the same, oh my god, they're all gonna aggro at the same time. Jesus Christ, man! Oh my god! This is not good! Ow. Oh my god! That actually... I am not used to attacks actually doing that in these games. Actually hitting you twice. That's pretty rare. Okay, well that extremely... Don't put me down! Don't put me back down here! That's why you rest at the bonfire after you warp to it. Tell you what, man. These are... Oh my god! Wow. Yeah. That's why you rise at the bonfire. Anyway. You're still asleep? You've been asleep for like the last two episodes, dude. Wake up.
Huh? No, no, I'm fine. Don't be like an old withering snake.
That never stops being funny. I adore it. I adore the man. Well, gee, it's kind of an awkward way to end, but I think that's pretty much going to do it for this episode. Apparently there was less left to do in New Londo than I thought there was. I think we pretty much cleaned it up. I'll do a little bit of, like, looking around, see if I missed anything there, but I'm pretty sure we're pretty much done down there. It's just whatever is on that bridge at the Valley of the Drakes, and I don't feel like going down there, because even with a Thunderstone Plate ring, those guys, like, triple-tap me. So, yeah. So, next time on Dark Souls, I actually think next time might be just, like, a montage of me fighting all those Taurus demons in the demon ruins in that drained lava lake. I don't know. But after that, we will make our way... We might actually go down to the Tomb of the Giants. I could see that.